I would like to thank Professor Su for this wonderful opportunity to visit Cast University and to have the chance to communicate with all of you. Since this is a lecture for 4 hours altogether, so let me begin with very briefly a plan or outline of this talk, in case we will get lost in the middle. Okay, so the plan of this talk. We will be given in 3 sections. The first one, I will start something that I assume that people here are familiar, is integration along Bolt manifold. And in the second part, I will talk about some work due to Bolt and Simonson, which concerns the geometry of G modulo T. And in the third part, talk about something on Schubert calculus. Yeah, this board is very, very good for writing that. Yeah. Okay. So basically, Schubert calculus. Suppose we have a Lie group. With a maximum torus basically Schubert calculus concern the computation in the cohomology ring of this quotient space. This manifold is known in algebraic geometry as so-called the complete flag manifold of G. And the understanding of this ring, cohomology ring, has lasted for many years, I think probably over 100 years, and was considered a very difficult ring. The ring structure is very difficult. On the other hand, for Bolt manifold, suppose we are giving a Bolt manifold. This ring is very simple, as everybody knows the Bolt manifold, the ring structure is very simple. And basically the work by Bolt and Simonson, I think it's, the paper is called, let me just think of what is the name of the book. Cohomology. By Bolt and Simonson. In 1955, published in the Proceeding of it's very short, only 4 pages paper. But later on, they have a full detailed account for this result. This one is the original one is short. In this paper, they introduce so-called the Bolt manifold and indicate the possibility to reduce the computation in this ring to the simpler ones. So in the first section, I will talk about the computation in this region. And in the second part, I will give you a brief introduction to the work by Bolt and Simonson, how to relate the geometry of G over T to this so-called Bolt manifold. And in the third part, we will make explicit computation so that we can really make a computation here to turn this computation in this region to this simpler one. This is something outlining the plan of the talk. Maybe today I could talk about this part and half of this part. Then next time I will carry on this discussion. Let me begin with so-called integration along Bolt manifold. So let me begin by the definition of Bolt manifold. So a C infinity manifold is called a Bolt manifold. Actually, in algebraic geometry, people say the Bolt-Simonson resolution instead of Bolt manifold. I learned this word from Professor Su. Yeah, it's called a Bolt manifold of rank n if there is a tour of smooth maps. Which start from this given manifold and M1. Let me denote this map by Pn minus 1, Pn minus 2, and P1 with the next properties. The first property says that the one at the end is simply two-dimensional sphere, which I denoted by S2. And the next property is about these maps. Each PK is a projection of an oriented S2 band and the third property is each PK has a section sigma k which goes from 2 k plus 1. So instead of this map are Faber bundle projection, but this each fib has a cross section which is the inverse order. Let me denote this n minus 1, sigma n minus 2, etc., which goes inverse order. So to be precise, let us fix a base point and with this base point we can furnish each MK with a base point. So if you take a base point here, you follow this series map to the kth stage, map this point to here. We denote this by mk. So this gives you a base point in the kth stage of this tour. And next, we can take a two-dimensional sphere, which is a pre-image of this at the base point. So assuming that you have here a base point, you look at the pre-image here, you get a two sphere which is embedded in this manifold. So I denote this by this is simply the fiber over this base point. And finally, we have embedding, I denote it by L k, which goes from S to k in M k, then followed by the section back to the total space. So assuming that you have the two sphere here, you have the inverse map which carry on these two sphere into the total space. So you get an embedding. This is really embedding because the section is always embedded, smooth embedding. So you get the point is that from this definition, you can easily verify this property. The two-dimensional homology of M has basis. L-K is the fundamental class of the two sphere. With k range between 1. So you consider the homology homomorphism induced by this map, which gives you a two-dimensional homology class which can be represented by two sphere. Actually, this set of geometrically represented two sphere gives you a basis for this two-dimensional homology of this. Speaking directly, in view of the standard property, so two-dimensional homology, cohomology, is a set of homomorphisms from two-dimensional homology into Z. You can specify a set of class by the next property. So this two-dimensional cohomology class considered as a homomorphism from this homology to the integers when it applied to this S2k is given by the Kronig symbol, which means it is 1 if R equal to k and 0 if otherwise. So we can define this cohomology. Actually, these classes are what we need to describe the cohomology, the additive cohomology of Bort manifold. Let me tell us. So So this set of two-dimensional cohomology class with is a basis. Sorry for two-dimensional cohomology of this Bartle manifold. Just because from this definition, with this actually the Dell basis of this basis element. More generally, for subset, let me write this as I1 IR to be a subset of 1 to n, then you can form a monomial to be simply the cup product of this R element, which gives you a 2R dimensional cohomology class of this Bort manifold. Then we have so-called the basis theorem. Cohomology classes. Is a basis for the cohomology of Bort manifold. So an immediately problem from this fact is that if you multiply two basis elements, so you get a cohomology class here. So you can expand this element in terms of this base element. Let me write the coefficient as this is just a property of the basis theorem, because you can express everything as a linear combination of this base element. So the problem is how to compute. These coefficients.
Maybe you want to write K in capital
letter,
right?
Yeah. Actually, in the later on, we will see in the Schubert calculus, you have similar problem, very similar to this one, almost somehow very similar problem to this one. So this is a problem which we will consider by so-called the integration along Bort manifold. So let me proceed. So this problem actually asks for the ring structure of this. Because by saying that this set is the basis for the cohomology, we just tells you the additive structure of this ring. But what we need to know, next step is the ring structure of our Bort manifold. Because the cohomology of a manifold is more than an abelian group. It has a multiplication. This is what we want to understand further. Yeah, to find the ring structure, we need to turn back to the definition of Bort manifold. So the section is very important. From the case stage to this map is the inverse order to the projection. So this one is the inverse. This section are always co-dimensional to embedding. So let me draw a picture. Let me say this is M chi. This is M chi plus 1. And sigma chi is a co-dimension embedding of this one into that one. Yeah, so you can look at the normal band of this embedding. Of this embedding. So this is a two-dimensional oriented bundle over MK. This is the bundle is over MK. It's a so you have so-called the Euler class of this manifold. So let me use EK to denote the Euler class, which is a two-dimensional cohomology class of the base manifold. Actually, by the induction, we can see that this two-dimensional cohomology is an abelian group with chi-generators, because this is also a Bort manifold. This is a Bort manifold. We have this statement. So there is a unique way to express this class in terms of this base element. So let us write this. Let me see how to. So there is a unique way to write this as a linear combination of this. So there is a unique way to express this as a linear combination of this basis element. So, so you get these integers. Let me have a definition. This definition could be the strict upper triangular matrix is called the structure matrix of the belt manifold. This is a strict up-triangular. I mean, you place everything to be zero on or below the diagonal, and place this this inches just vertical direction, then you get this matrix. And using this matrix, you can have a presentation for the integral cohomology ring of this Bort manifold. Which says that the integral cohomology of this Bort manifold is a polynomial, free polynomial ring generated by this x1 to xn, this kind of element, subject to our n relations. Where TR is given by XR square equal to XR times ER. I just using ER to denote this this expression. Actually, the proof is if one knows so-called Larry Hirsch property, the proof is quite straightforward. Let me just very briefly give you a proof of this fact. We can assume that some general, let assume that P to X be a oriented S2 fibration over a topology space X. We don't need to, this space is to be a manifold, just a arbitrary two-sphere fibration over this topology manifold. But we should ask, there is a section, this band, with a section. From X back to M. This is always in opposite direction. And in this case, we also have let gamma be the normal band. This co-dimension 2 embedding, you can always talk about the normal bundle, and we can also talk about the Euler class of this normal bundle. In this case, there is a unical class belong to the total space such that if you restrict this X to the fiber, which generate this is a generator. This is something very notation is you look at a fiber, you can restrict this class to the fiber sphere, you get a two-dimensional class here, which is a generator. And the next property, if you apply the section to this class, you get zero. This is a class back to the base space. That is the unique one, satisfy this property. And further, the cohomology of the total space is a module over the cohomology of the base space with two basis elements. One is one, another is x, but subject to the relation. X squared equal to x times eta. So you just repeatedly apply this principle to every stage of the projection in the board tour. You get this relation repeatedly. You get this relation. Is this proof too short? Yeah, we will see. Yeah. Okay. Oh, yeah, thanks. Thanks. So now I just want to talk about what is called the integration along the Bort manifold. So from this in the numerator part, you have a quotient map into the cohomology of a Bort manifold. You have a very natural quotient map because this is the quotient ring of this guy. So you have an obvious quotient map. So let me look at this. This is a polynomial ring. Has a polynomial in every degree. But I will look at those has homogeneous degree n. Means the part of homogeneous degree n, then this part will go to the cohomology of Bort manifold of degree 2n. But this is a manifold with degree 2n is a top degree, so this is integers. So let me write this map as integration along M. So the problem is compute. So you have a quotient map which goes to Z. So each polynomial here must correspond to an integer here. So what's the integer? How can we compute the value of this? Actually, I use this symbol because this symbol comes from the Drum theory. But speaking homology, if we think of this as the home H2n of m into z, you will find that this is a cyclic group of one generators, which is generated by the fundamental class of this. So the actually this value should be given by the so-called quaternic pairing between homology and the fundamental class and the homology. So in drum theory, this is really the integration along the whole manifold. These are the same thing. So I use this symbol. Yeah, I need more place. So to present the answer to this problem, I need to introduce a so-called the triangular operator. Suppose we are given upper triangular matrix by this I mean the entries are all integers, and using this matrix, you can define so-called the triangular operator. From the set of homogeneous polynomials in degree n into Z by the following rule. Actually, this is given by composition of a sequence of operations. Let me denote this by Tn, which goes to x1, xn minus 1, degree decreased by 1, and the variable also less than 1, Tn minus 2, which goes to yeah, I should have Tn minus 1, let me see.
You have Tn minus, Tn
minus 2,
so it means that.
Oh, let me see. Minus 1, yeah. Yeah,
so right.
So, because this operator is given by similarly to a sequence of this, so I need only to describe this TR, what happens to TR will be sufficient. So the TR is a linear map when it acts on a normal mu. Sorry, T chi, too many R's. T chi which is zero if is equal to zero, which is I keep this monomial, the first command is one part fixed, not change, but only do a little trick here. I just replace this one by a linear form. This linear form depends only on the kth column of this matrix, which is given as follows. I look at the kth column of this matrix, then construct this linear form. You could see that this operator has a way to decrease the degree of this monomial by one, and reduce the variable also by one. You can only find k minus one variable in this expression. If you check this definition, you will find that this T1 is given by, T1 is I times X1, you take off the coefficient. So this is really map goes to Z. And this algorithm can be always effectively calculated. So let me give you the answer to this problem. Then if you apply the integration to a polynomial here, f here, then it is the same as you apply the upper triangular operator defined by this matrix to this polynomial. We'll have a break just after the we give a proof for this. Maybe the time is too long for one session. the proof is somehow also straightforward. Actually, there were two ideas for this proof. The first one is this. Suppose we have we consider the kth stage in the Bortor, which is a S2 fibration, which is embedded in MK. We have projection minus one into MK. In this case, we have, let me see. which is the span of x1, x cat, just as G has mentioned. And in this case, we have for any class B in the base space, then you take integration along M chi, cup product x with P chi minus 1. Yeah, you apply this induced cohomology map of this to this class B, you get a class back here. Then you take product, cup product, you get a class here. So if you integrate this class along the total space, which is the same as you take integration of class B on the base space. Actually this can be directly verified by using the property, the quantic pair can be directly. But in drum theory, people call this integration by part. This is just a result of integration by part. So this is a way to reduce this integration on the total space to the integration on the base space. Yeah, this formula is somehow like let me see. The second idea is if you look at x k to power r.
So you are taking integration x k cut product of what is x?
This x k.
Yes.
This is not true if you place square here. It's not true. Just for one. Yeah, if you look at x k to power r, then by the relation gr, you can write this as x k r minus 1 to the linear form because gr means if r is equal to 2, this relation holds. So you multiply both sides by, if you repeat this using gr, what you get is x chi times I. Just apply this relation several times, you could get this one. Combining these two parts, you could actually, this indicate why we make substitution of this term by this one. You keep everything in the base, this somehow a class in the base space. This is a class in the base space, like the B here. But you need to replace this by this part, and this formula tells you you can get away of this one if you do one step further. So these are two ideas. You can directly establish this. So this is the first section of talk about the integration along Bode manifold. Actually, at the end, we will see that the Schubert calculus can be done by using this formula. ingredients to define this operator. Did I go too fast?
No.
Sorry. Yeah, this. Just for 1 hour. So we have a break.
Yes. Yeah.